It's time now for Health Fitness Broadcast with Sherry, a show covering the hottest fitness topics and latest health issues. And now, here's your host, Sherry Horner.
Welcome, everyone, to the show. I'm so excited about today's show. I'd like to introduce our guest today. She is world-renowned fitness expert, trainer to the trainers. She's an icon in the fitness industry, the one, the only, and the very humble, Kathy Friedrich. Kathy, welcome to the show.
Oh, thanks so much, Sherry. It's a pleasure to be on the show.
Again, it's only been 6 or so years.
It's been a while. Lots has happened since then. So
yeah, absolutely. Thanks for coming back. This is very exciting time, not only for you but for us. And I want to mention, Kathy was the fifth interview on the show when we started back in 2004. So it's been a while, but you have great things going on. Which is, number one is your induction into the National Fitness Hall of Fame. I bet you're just totally excited about that.
I am. I'm so honored and proud to be the recipient of that award. I can't even begin to tell you of all the things that I've accomplished in my career. I would have to say this is the one that just seals the deal for me, where it's just like, okay, it's official now, you know. So it's just a wonderful feeling, and I couldn't be happier over winning this.
So how did you find out? How did they notify you?
Well, they notified me through email saying that I've been nominated, had to fill out some paperwork, and then they said, you know, within a few weeks I would hear back whether I was chosen or not. So I got the good word and, you know, jumped for joy and did my little happy dance.
Yeah. I am excited for you. When I heard
Thank
that
you.
News, I was like, it's well overdue. It's well deserved, but well overdue in my opinion. But,
thank you. I appreciate that.
So, you've been in the fitness industry for over 30 years.
Yeah.
Right? And,
I know, scary,
so how old were you when you started? 12?
I know. No, actually it was, 16, I believe, going on 17. And, I just took a class. It was my girlfriend's birthday, and she said, you know, I'm going to this class at Elaine Powers. You want to come? At the time, I was always active, did gymnastics and track and field, but never took an official fitness class. So when I went there, I said, wow. I mean, immediately, as soon as I started that class, I was like, this is great. I just felt like this energy come out of me, and I thought, I want to be doing this. I really wanted to be doing it. So she was like, I did another class and another class, and she's like, all right. You know, we couldn't drive at the time. She had to call her mom. She's like, I'm going home. And I said, well, I'm staying. And so I called my mom later to pick me up, and I asked them for all this literature, and, you know, the next thing I knew, I was home memorizing routines, and 3 weeks later, standing up there giving my own. It was just my calling.
Wow. In 3 weeks. That's amazing. That's amazing.
It was like my everything, you know, the way you couldn't get me to study my grades in school that hard. But for this, it was just like every time my parents came to the living room, they're like, are you doing that again? I'm like, yes, be quiet. I got to time this.
That's great. So since then, you have you're really a pioneer in the fitness industry. You've produced over 170 videos, exercise DVDs. Is that right?
Over that and you know, more on the way. It'll be an ongoing thing. And the really neat thing about it is I'm not sure if you're familiar with the trend of silver sneakers programs and things.
Mm-hmm.
But these
yes.
These are, okay. These are certified programs that are out there for seniors of, you know, anywhere from 75 and above. So the industry has a place for group fitness and personal trainers all the way up through these advanced years. So, you know, we'll keep going until, as long as people keep coming, we'll keep going.
Yeah, that is great. So that's your next series in line?
Well, no, I mean, I do teach that class, but, you know, eventually I will make a series for that. But right now my focus is still, as it always has been, is advanced workouts. I do realize, though, that, you know, with my age going up and my following along with me, I'm fortunate enough to have started in my 20s and still have a very strong following that has gone with me through the 20s, 30s, and now we're in our 40s. But I even have clientele up through 60s that are still doing plyometrics and very aggressive workouts. And but, you know, our joints start talking to us at this point in life. So I do understand that, you know, you have to do balance, high intensity, low intensity, mix it up, do longer warm-ups, do more stretching, and be kinder to your body so that you can, you know, put a few more extra recovery days in there, and then you're good to go. As long as you honor your body, it will perform for you.
I like that. Remember that. As long as you honor your body, it will perform for you, and that is so true. Later in the show, I want to talk about all of the different series of DVDs that you have, but I want to take you back to that induction into the National Fitness Hall of Fame. So the ceremony, now there's a ceremony coming up for that, is there?
Yes, it's in March 5th at the Arnold Sports Festival in Ohio. So I don't know all the details as to how that's going to play out, but I do know that I will be presented an award, and, you know, and I believe there's five other, or I am one of five other inductees coming in. I'm not exactly sure who all the other winners are, so, you know, it's just going to be, we're going to have a big meet and greet there and get to know one another, and it's just, it's, you know, going to be fantastic.
That whole event is fantastic. So, and
yes,
it,
from
it,
what
it,
I, go ahead.
Oh, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, from what I understand, it might be the first, I could be wrong, but I think it's the first time they are holding it in conjunction with this Arnold Festival. So I think everybody's kind of walking into it with new footings and seeing, you know, how it's going to, you know, the itinerary will change now. But in the past, I think it was held more local to where the induction location is, mm-hmm. and the Fitness Hall of Fame location is, I should say. And I think they gave you a tour of the museum back then, but now we won't have access to that, so it'll be a new format. So I'm excited to see how it all plays out.
Yeah, I think it's going to be exciting. You'll have to give us recap on what you experienced there. So
I will.
You started back when you were a teenager, and so when you started, did you, of course, it was in your blood. And I always say this to all trainers. Once we are in the industry and then you try to walk away and do something else, it always calls you back.
Exactly.
So I'm sure you've seen a lot of trainers come and go and come back.
Right.
And you've been the trainer to the trainer, your master trainer. So you have actually trained some of the best instructors in the industry.
Yeah, it's just one of those things, like you just follow your passion, and it just, I know some people will open a book and try to go to a career thing and see what they want to do for a living, but that plan, you know, I'm not going to say it never works, but I think when you just find what your passion is, and it'll just be your calling, and success just follows because you're always happy doing what you're doing. And I, you know, once I took that class back at Elaine Powers, I was like, that's it, I'm hooked. And I just could not rest at night. I needed to know where I could go, what I could do. And fortunately, at the time, there was a company called Creative Instructors Aerobics just emerging right along when I was, you know, with my ideas of craziness of, like, where, you know, thirsty, where can I go with this? And I noticed that they were located right in Philadelphia, which was like 15 minutes away from me, and they were doing this really unique concept where they were taking fitness DVD, oh, at the time of VHS, of course, and putting programs on there for instructors all around the country to be able to purchase and get ideas to teach for their classes. So I said, oh, that's interesting, and I went and watched one of them, and I saw the credits go up, and like I said, it was 15 minutes for me, so I called up and I said, what do I do to be one of the backup people on this? This is really interesting to me. He's like, oh, come down and audition. So I auditioned, and he's like, how would you like to be the lead? And I was like, oh, my gosh, are you kidding? So that, of course, got me excited about doing DVDs, and so I did my very first project with this company, Creative Instructors Aerobics, and it was called Step in Motion 1, and it put me on the map in all of fitness. It was basically a sellout. We took it to a big national convention that IDEA put out, and we had Nike and Reebok and all their employees coming around going, who is this girl? Where'd she come out of? You know, and so we sold out completely. We couldn't even get more in time. It was, like I said, it was the number one selling step DVD of its, or video of its time back then. And then I ran into my next struggle, well, you know, my first struggle, I should say, which was, okay, you know, how do I get my name out there? It's really hard to get yourself out there without exhausting yourself and traveling and traveling and traveling. And when I would try to approach production or distributors to carry my DVD, I keep saying DVD, but back then it was obviously VHS tapes. You know, it was like, it's great that you're wonderful and that you can teach fitness and you've been doing it all these years. But basically their attitude was, if you're not a celebrity, they're not interested, because you really, they need to know that when you see a picture on the outside of the box, people identify and be like, oh, that's Cher, or that's Jane Fonda, or whatever. So it was real discouraging, and all of a sudden one day, I constantly kept trying to figure out how I was going to get my foot in the door and get my product on the shelves, and all of a sudden one day I get a phone call from a customer saying, you know, I'd like to order more. And I was like, oh, well, how did you hear about us? And she's like, from the Internet. And I said, the Internet? And she's like, yeah. And I said, well, what do you mean? She's like, oh, a group of us are on the Internet. We talk about your tapes, and they told me about it. So I typed in exercise, this, that. I couldn't find my tape. And then all of a sudden I typed in my name, and boom, all this word came up about me. It was like weird, you know. I'm like, how did that happen? So that's when we kind of, my business partner Chris and myself, that's when we discovered the power of the Internet. And it was like, oh my God, I think I finally found the answer for me to go to the next level, skip over the distributors who kept, like, you know, shutting the door in my face. And so we said, hey, let's start a website, and put down $19.95 and put this website out there, and on the first day made $645, which may not sound like a lot, but with no advertising and no one even knowing, and you just kind of put that out there, you can only imagine. Mm-hmm. 20 years later, and with the successes of things and products that have gone out and word of mouth beyond that, where you can grow into. So the company is very successful now. I'm very proud of it. It's come a long, long way, and I owe it all to that woman who made that phone call back then.
Yes, we all have that one person in our lives, right, that makes a statement or ask a question that really sets your whole future in motion. And
right,
that your online, your website was like one of the first websites,
yes,
online to sell exercise DVDs or videos online.
Yeah, I really do think we were the pioneer in that. I mean, I could hardly think of any other instructor, unless it was a large company like Reebok or Nike or something. But individual private instructors having their own website was like, I would have to, you know, I would still get those looks of what, huh? You know, it just wasn't out there. So I had that huge advantage of getting it out there. Now, of course, anywhere you look, everyone has their own website, or pretty much, you know, it's very common.
Yes, but
so,
I should just say that yours is at the top. Yours is ranked really high, and it's not only totally functional and very attractive, the whole layout, but it's ranked really high too. So you continue to stand your ground. And with that first video that you produced, you really kind of set the stage for other instructors, because there wasn't a lot of advanced workouts. Everything was kind of beginner to intermediate levels, and you kind
right
of set the stage to, hey, let's take it up to the next level.
Right, and that all goes back to following your passion, because so many of those distributors that I mentioned earlier that were shutting the door in my face were like, you're just incredibly hard, and people, you know, we want things watered down. The people that are doing these are couch potatoes. And I was just offended, and for what they were saying about the others as well. I mean, like, give them credit. They would step up to the plate if you showed them that. And so it was just crazy that they felt that way. And I thought, well, you know what? I didn't build my following or get to where I am right now, even though it might not be where they want me to be, from feeling defeated and all that. So I was like, obviously people enjoy what I do, and I'm just going to stick to my guns and find a way to get it accessible to everyone. So, you know, now I can kind of go, see ya. So I, you know, I still do advanced tapes. It's still what my forte is. It's still what my number one seller is. Of course, I'm now branching out and doing things for intermediate and beginner and, you know, things that are not just all high impact, high intensity. We have low impact things. We offer a wide variety of things. But my forte and my niche of what put me on the map is the high impact activities. And, you know, and I'll always have one of those with every series that I do to, you know, give my following that's amazingly still been with me, you know, as long as I have from day one. I still have my very first class that I taught when I went to the company that I'm with now, which is my own company with Chris. But at the time when I was in college, it was his on his own. Before we even started the DVD business, he just had his own health club. When I walked in there and taught, do you know that there are three people that still come and take the class with me 30-something years later now. So it's
That's amazing. They're like family to you now.
Yeah, so, you know, that's total devotion, and I just think people wouldn't do that if you didn't follow your dreams and your passion and give them what, you know, everything you have in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yes, you are very passionate and very humble. I mentioned that at the beginning of the show. I also want to mention to everyone a few things that you've been featured in. A lot of magazines, the New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Dallas News, Fox Business News. You've been on QVC, Philadelphia Inquirer. Those are some magazines. And, of course, Shape, Oxygen, Self, Health, and Fit Consumer Digest, and many others. So those are just
busy.
So not only are you everywhere, but where you're not, they're talking about you, and it's all good news. But I want to talk about the different types of series that you've designed, because a lot of instructors that produce their own DVDs, they kind of touch on their niche, but then try to touch on a few other things. But you just take one type of exercise and create a whole series. And I think that's very great. It's very interesting, and for someone to follow the whole series. So can you tell us about the different series that you have designed?
Well, we started way back early, you know, with just in the beginning it was just one or two at a time, and then we started realizing that people would ask us, how do I do this, what do I put it with? So that's when the philosophy of designing series came up, because if they kind of put it in this bundle, then I could create rotations and things for them to say, okay, on this day you do this one and that one and that one, and that's worked out really well. But one of our huge undertakings, which we did with NFL Films, was my biggest puppy, and probably would never do one that big again, because it was called the Shock Training System Series, and it was all based on, oh my goodness, 36 workouts. It was a 3-month rotation, and we still have it available, and it's still a very, very popular seller, because you will guaranteed you're going to get results. It's all laid out for you. I've pretty much taken any guesswork. Like, at first you'll see, oh, 36 DVDs. My God, this must be so crazy, and I don't know if I could do it. But the reason it is that many DVDs is because I've done all the homework, and pretty much you pop in this day, and this is everything you need the next day. So it goes on for 3 months like that, and then you can repeat it and do it again, or and then we have programs that we can give you in between, you know, recovery programs, and then if you want to take a break between it and then go back and do it again. So it's very comprehensive, very effective and thorough, and it's all based on shock training. And so you have a 3-tiered program. You start with muscle endurance for 12 weeks. You go to strength for 12 weeks and hypertrophy for 12 weeks. And then, you know, by the end of that, your muscles have completely strengthened and changed and gotten nice and lean, and it's a great series. We have so many testimonials on our website just for shock training, the shock training series. I call it STS. It's much easier to say.
Mm-hmm.
And then they write in and tell us about how it's changed their life. So the testimonials are wonderful.
Speaking of testimonials, is there anyone, because you have a lot of people emailing you and telling you what a difference, and I've noticed some online, what a difference that you and your videos have made in their lives. Is there any one success story that has really touched you in a special way?
One that really touched my heart was not just so much the workouts, but the camaraderie around the workouts. We also offer road trips. And on these road trips, it's basically when a group of people who know about our workouts and just form this love for them, so they want to come visit us. And I'll get into the road trips later if you want to know more about them. But basically, this woman, she came on a road trip, was completely into the workouts, meeting me and whatever. And then 4 months later, when she went home, she found out that she was diagnosed with ovarian cancer and at an advanced aggressive phase. And she was like, oh, my gosh. And just from the road trip friends that she made, and she told them, we all pulled together. We made these bands of, teal bands for courage. And we circulated a T-shirt around the country of all Catholics around the country. Everyone put their handprint on it, sent it to her, all these positive vibes to get her through her 18 chemotherapy treatments. And now, knock on wood, she looks phenomenal. She's come to 2 road trips, and actually, I think she's already been on a 3rd now, and she's strong, and she, runs marathons. She also, she does 5Ks, I should say, and she also does the workouts, and she's feeling more strength and love from, not just the workouts themselves, but the support that she's gotten through the family we've created on the road trip. So it really warms you to see people come together, and the energy that we create and give to someone, it's hard to explain that, but, there's a lot of emotion in the room, and it really can give you this positive shot of adrenaline that can take you through some very, very tough times.
Mm-hmm. Seeing some video clips and some photos of your road trips, you can see everybody's just ecstatic about not only training in person with you, because a lot of these people have never met you in person. They've just been doing your exercise DVDs for years.
Right.
And they get a chance to meet you in person and exercise with you. So tell me about the road trip, because did it start with just an annual event? Is that how it started?
It was funny, like one time someone emailed and said, do you ever do workouts for people? Like if I brought a group of friends with me, would you be able to do a workout for us? So I said, okay. And like, this is way back, oh gosh, I don't even know how many years ago, well over 10. And we did this group that came, and they were friends, and they all came in, and there was like 11 of them, and then they told their friends, and then they said, could you do it again? And I said, okay. And so that turned into 24, and then they're like, the word got out, and this group got together and went on a forum and told people, and then it was like up to 50. And I said, okay, this is gonna be crazy. So we had to stop for a while because our facility was too small. So then when we opened our new facility, it had a huge aerobic room, so we were able to open it to 106 people. And at that point, we changed the whole format. We made it one long weekend where they had to sign up ahead of time. And believe it or not, when we announced we're going to sign these, we're going to do the sign up, and we've sold out for the 106 slots in 3 minutes. It's like that popular.
Wow.
And, they just, they can't get enough. So 1 year we even did 2 of them back to back with, just to try to service more people who really, really want to come on them. It's grown into be such a phenomenal thing that we were asked to come out to other states. People were like, well, we can't fly in. Can you fly to us? So we started doing them around the country. And this summer we're going to be doing it at Disney World.
And in great.
October we're going, yeah. And then we're, I'm looking forward to getting Mickey in on this. He better just join me and do some sort of workout. So it's going to be
that
great.
Is great.
It is great. And then families can bring their children, and they'll see Mickey exercising. It's a good message to send children. It's a good message for families, So, and then we'll be going to Chicago in October. We've already done California. We've done Florida.
Texas.
Right. We've had many. They've been very, very successful. Each and every one, it's like I said, it's an incredible bonding experience. And it's a wonderful way for me to give back to my loyal customers who've been with me for years, come onto their stomping grounds. They just love to show me. They bring me all these gifts about their state, and they're just so excited.
Oh, local culture.
Yeah. It's a wonderful, wonderful experience.
That
is great. And I hope you can come on one.
Yes, I know. Well, I'm just about 20 minutes from you. So I've always noticed that your one in New Jersey is in August. So every year I'm scoping out August going, I should have signed up. But you throw me a media pass, I'll be there in a heartbeat.
Okay. Yeah, we'll definitely get you in. If you want to come, you're in. I'll
Okay. That's great. I want to ask you about your crew in your DVDs. These ladies, I've noticed over the years and throughout different series that they are in multiple videos with you. And so tell us about your bond with these ladies, because they must be very dedicated to you to let you put them through that torture of...
It, you know, it started out in the very beginning where I just asked a couple of members, and that was these cast members that you're seeing. They were just members at the gym. They weren't even instructors yet, but then later some of them became instructors because they were so like, wow, I love this. But they pretty much were available at the gym to do one. They loved it so much, and they did more and more, and I am extremely fortunate because things come up in people's lives. They have babies. They, you know, move or whatever, you know, it's, and they have to take time off, but these girls have stuck with me through all their life changes. They work their lives around when I film, and I've been extremely fortunate, and I love them to death, and they are in incredible shape, as you know from doing the workouts. They know what I need. I can pretty much create a DVD in an hour, and they will look flawless behind me because they're so conditioned to the way I work out. That being said, though, we did have a Daytona road trip, and in that was a audition to be in the next DVDs. Two girls did such a phenomenal job that I couldn't decide on one. Well, we had like a lot of people, but it came down to two girls that I couldn't make a decision on, so I invited them both as winners, and they were so strong. They were just featured in the last series that we just did. They were so strong. People were writing in saying, we can't even tell the difference between the girls that were regulars and the newbies. And just phenomenal. And the rehearsals were hysterical because when we sit around and we do moves, and the girls that were with me for years, I would say, okay, did I do this in other videos? And they're like, And the two newbies would jump up and go, nope, this is from this workout. And they'd name it all down to the chapter
point.
Down to I was like, wow, this is great.
So they are like, all of your following, so to speak, are called cathletes for cat.
Yes.
Kathy athletes. So your cathletes, now these are like the American cathletes, you know, it's like the American Idol. They both were the American cathletes of fitness. So you have two sons, and I bet they are so proud of you.
Oh, they are. They're so cute. They just, anything, when I won that award, my one son was just so, his eyes watered up, and he was just like, you know, he's looking at his brother and saying, did you hear mommy won? She won, she won. And we started jumping up and down. And they just, you know, they're young. They're 8 and 10. They're young enough where they're not fully understanding business and the way business works. But when they were like maybe 2 years younger than they are now, it was just so cute. I would be in my office. And, of course, the office is filled with events for work and whatever. And things really neat, momentum type things, monumental type things are hanging all over that we've done. And so the kids are really cute because they'll be like, mommy, is it weird to you to have your name all over your office like this? And then things will come in the mail and they're like, that's you. And then we'll walk through the store and they're like, that's you on that box, you know? So I think that they're slowly getting it, and it's very, very cute to see.
Yeah, that's special.
Yeah.
I want to ask you before we go, if you can give a tip or two, a fitness tip to anyone just getting started or someone looking for their next challenge.
Sure. I mean, I always, for, you know, a beginner to intermediate person, I always want to say, you need to crawl before you walk, before you run. A lot of times people just, when they are in the mood, they finally say, I've had it. They're probably pretty out of shape and haven't done anything, and they finally just had this moment where they said, I'm going to do it. And I see this time and time again. They will jump in and do way too much too soon. And because they are not sure what they're doing, they actually feel so sore and everywhere, and they can barely walk, and they're like, oh, my God, people do this? It's not for me, or they run the risk of an injury. It doesn't have to be that brutal. If you just make small changes, start with walking 10 minutes a day and then increasing that. You always just need to make small changes, and obviously diet and healthy eating is you know, a separate thing that you do need to do in addition to your exercise. But as far as your exercise is concerned, I try to tell people, like, keep it as simple as possible. When you're a beginner, you know, 10 minutes three times a week, then you can start altering things like the duration, meaning the day that you work out. You can take it from 10 to 15. I try to tell them another time, alter your frequency, which would mean how many days of work you do it, how many days a week you do it. You could do 1 week three times a week, another week four times, and on one time you could just play with the time. You do just 10 minutes or 15 minutes. You can also vary the intensity. One workout, push it a little harder, another one back off. And then you can combine all three of those elements. One time, push hard, go four times a week, and at 15 minutes, you know, so it, all those elements, if you do too much too soon, it'll blow you away and you'll be discouraged. So just make small changes and be consistent and focused and committed. And in no time, you know, you will all of a sudden just start having more energy, looking great, and being like, wow. People will start noticing and saying, you look different, you know. And it didn't have to kill you to make it happen.
I like that. Didn't have to kill you to make it happen. Okay.
Right.
that's great. That's a good tip. It's time for us to go, but I want to thank you again, Kathy. What a great life that you have, and I know you know that.
Thank you.
But you've made such a great positive impact on so many people, and I want to thank you for sharing everything with us. And congratulations again for your induction into the Fitness Hall of Fame. And
I greatly appreciate that.
It's time for us to go, and let's keep in touch, okay?
Okay.
All right. Thanks.
Very good. Thank you again for having me. Take care.
As we say goodbye, I'd like to remind you to take some time to relax, to reflect back on the success of your day. Enjoy that good, positive feeling of knowing you're doing everything you can to take care of your health.